In this video, I'll continue to talk about my vision of the Angular application structure. We will look at the model folder that contains descriptions of the basic business data objects, and how I suggest using and where to store types, interfaces, and enums. All code can be found in public GitHub repository, which will be expanded with each new video. So subscribe to my channel to stay updated. This is my models folder. In this folder, I store types that describe the crucial data objects used in the project. I only put here those models that are important for the entire project as a whole. A good example is the user model, since the user is the main actor in our application, and the task model reflects the main objects that the user and the application will operate. I especially emphasize that in this folder I only store business data object models, because very often developers start storing all the interfaces that they have in the project in one folder. To avoid confusing models with other interfaces, I use model in the extension and the type keyword instead of interface in the model declaration. The models folder is one of the most important parts of your application structure from a semantic point of view, so keep it lighter and cleaner. Technically, the model is very similar to an interface, and the type is just an alias for the interface keyword. But from a semantic perspective, it's a blueprint of a business data object. In fact, it could be represented as a class in which interface fields become properties and behavior and validation methods could be added. But I prefer to keep model simple and be focused on data structure description. I store behavior in services and validation logic as a part of component logic that directive forms belong to. Here's what the task class could potentially look like. I use interfaces to describe what is expected of something, and they make sense in the context in which they are applied. For example, the avatar component expects input parameters that are described by iUserAvatarInputData. Any developer who uses this component can easily know what he needs to pass as input. In this case, the interface plays the role of describing what the avatar component expects for input. For interfaces like this, I use the I prefix and the word interface in the extension to distinguish them from models. I keep them close to a component in the component folder. Sometimes I use types for abstraction, like here. The changeable object is not a model, it's a union of types which should implement the iChangeable object interface and could be set as property of the change object. I keep the changeable object type and iChangeable object interface definitions in the same file with the change model for more cohesion, since they can be considered as part of the model description. For all properties that are associated with enumerable set of values, such as types, states, etc., I prefer to use enums instead of strings or numbers. It helps avoid spelling errors in string constants, and also gives information about all allowed values for some property that is helpful for the development process. I initialize all enums with meaningful string literals that are helpful for debugging. The E prefix distinguishes enum from other classes to improve code readability. I don't use a special folder for enums and store them where their original context exists. For example, task statuses and types make sense to be part of task model file. You may notice that I'm using an index file for the model folder. I'm doing this to make it easy to see all the folder definitions in one place. This will also be useful for shortening input statements. I'd love to hear your thoughts on my way of using types, interfaces, and enums to describe models. In the description, you can find links to a repository with the code on GitHub and to the peer containing comments on the video. And don't forget about likes. Thank you.